What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of the Venom vlog, and I'm starting to lose my voice, so I'm going to try to get this in real quickly and talk about a Venom and Carnage series that is available on the Marvel Unlimited app, which I think you can get right now if you put in the code Quantum. As of me recording this, I think the code is still going. It gives you like 2 months for only $5 each month, which is half the price of what normally costs. And what Marvel Unlimited is, it's just a cool little app where you can read comics digitally. So if you don't use Comixology or anything else, or Kindle books, you can use the Marvel Unlimited app and pick up, you know, Marvel comic books that are fairly recent, and then stuff that goes all the way back years and decades and stuff. So it's really cool. It's a neat app, and they have exclusive comics on there, and they've done stuff for Moon Knight. They did like a Venom one-shot that was on there that kind of told his origins in a new way. And then they have this series, which is Venom versus Carnage. And this is written by Carla Pacheco, and it's art by Scott Hepburn. And this is a four-issue story, and the comics are kind of drawn, you know, top to bottom, like on a phone. So you have it at that ratio, which is cool. So I have some of it, you know, some of the artwork and stuff up here and me scrolling through it. And it's just, it's a really neat way to check out comics. And it also, I think, challenges some of the artists on how to draw their comics, because typically it's panel, and you have it set up a certain way. But doing it this way, where you scroll through things, it's pretty neat. You know, the Moon Knight one by Jeff Lemire was really good. And then having this one was really neat too, because the way they approach the storytelling is really fun. And what they do with the artwork, Scott Hepburn clearly had a lot of fun doing symbiote stuff and having, you know, symbiote ooze dripping down and all this stuff, and having like lightning spell the word Carnage, all these cool little things in the artwork that I really dug. So for this story, basically, without getting into too many spoilers, because I would love for you all to check it out yourself, but the basic broad strokes of this is that it's just like a fun throwback, almost 90s approach to a Venom versus Carnage story. Almost feels like maybe Carla Pacheco got some of the information of what the new movie, you know, Venom Let There Be Carnage, back when that was a new movie. It almost feels like she got a couple beats of what that story might entail, and then decided, okay, let's do like a kind of a crazier version of that, where it's just Venom versus Carnage, because there's big over-the-top action in it, a lot of fighting on top of, you know, rooftops and things like that, but there's also like helicopters and Carnage taking over a helicopter, and then, you know, it starts off, it's just like Eddie on a plane, and his symbiote senses that Carnage is nearby, and down below, Carnage is driving to like the Hoover Dam, and he's like in a, you know, sportsmobile or old automobile, so kind of reminiscent of like the movie a little bit. And then they collide, they fight on the Hoover Dam, and then, you know, Carnage takes over this helicopter and takes him and Eddie over to Las Vegas, where the helicopter crashes, and then they fall down to Las Vegas and begin, you know, or continue their battle there. And that's pretty much what issues 2 through 4 are. It's just this big battle in Vegas where you have all the monuments and all like the iconography of Vegas and them fighting around it, you know. So it's kind of fun in that regard. The dialogue's very kind of cheesy and 90s, very fun like that. And, you know, a lot of one-liners and zingers and stuff between the two characters. A lot of, you know, using their symbiotes to, like, attack each other and hurt each other. But also, you know, Carnage turning into liquid, bonding with a storm at one point, using liquid in the air to, like, make himself bigger, and combining with a giant thunderstorm that's coming through, and then eventually raining down all over the citizens of Vegas and creating a bunch of carnages all over the city. So this is probably not in continuity, because if it was, Vegas would have been destroyed during the Absolute Carnage storyline, where if he went around taking everyone's codices, you know, he would have killed everyone that visited Las Vegas that day. So I'm guessing this is not in continuity. It's just like a fun Venom versus Carnage story. And I highly recommend you checking out. Like I said, I think the artwork's really fun. I think Carla Pacheco wrote like a very fun 90s throwback, you know, goofy storyline where it doesn't take itself too seriously. And it has a lot of fun with it. And like I said, it has a lot of like dumb one-liners and dad jokes. And I kind of enjoyed it. So if you haven't read the Marvel Unlimited, or if you haven't had access to the app, I would say check it out. You know, at least give it a chance. You know, check it out for like a month or two. And if that Quantum code is still going, you can check it out. You can get 2 months for the price of 1 month. So $5 per month. And you can check it out for 2 months and read a bunch of the stuff that's on there. And I don't know. I recommend it. I subscribe to this app like probably twice a year. I'll get it for like a month or two, binge the stuff I've missed, and then, you know, cancel my subscription and then come back later. But if you're someone who always likes to have access to digital comics, you want like an infinite library of just older comics from Marvel that you can read at any time, this is a really good app and it's worth the money for it. So definitely check it out and check out this story and let me know what you think. If you read this or not down below, I'd love to hear your thoughts. Let it be known in the comments and we can keep talking down there. We can maybe get into some more spoilers down there. But, you know, for right now, just saying, without getting into too many spoilers, this was a fun story. You get to see Carnage in a couple of different ways. Like I said, as a giant cloud monster, as a bunch of citizens of Las Vegas, you get to see him in a bunch of different ways and fighting Venom, and Venom definitely being the underdog in this fight, and you know trying to shine through and save the day and be the Eddie Brock that a lot of us know and love after he's become more of an anti-hero. So it's very fun. So check it out for sure. Okay, my throat is definitely killing me now, so I gotta go. Thanks so much for watching the show, as always. Like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you in the next episode. Peace.